Oh, hello everyone! Welcome to day 3 of our Facebook Live Teach here in Self-Publishing Made Simple. Hi, I'm Emmy. Hello, welcome back. And today I'm going to share with you some of my secrets on how I launched my books to number one bestseller status on Amazon during my launch week, even if I don't have a publicist or a large social media following. You know, this is something that people have been asking me and they're really interested to know about this. So this is what I'm going to deliver to you today. So we know that writing a book is amazing and getting it published is absolutely fantastic. But getting it to number one bestseller status is just that extra sweet icing on the cake. So I'll share with you three of my secrets that will help you to get started with this, okay? So the first secret has something to do with the topic. You know, it has, I think it's quite obvious that you need to have a book that people will be interested in, you know, that people are willing to buy and to read. Now, you might be wondering, okay, that's fair enough. You know, write a book, it depends on the topic. But a lot of aspiring authors actually do struggle with this. They always ask, there's so much that I can write about. What should I write about? Shall I write about what's interesting to me? Shall I write about my expertise? You know, there's so many things that you can write about. So I'll give you an example. In my case, I'm a psychologist. So at the start, I was thinking, okay, psychology is so broad. Maybe I should write about what I specialize in. And if I followed that route, I probably will end up writing about discourse analysis or multiple regression analysis or rational emotive therapy, you know, that kind of stuff. But I had to pause and think whether this is the kind of book that people will be interested to read and buy. You know, surely there will be academics who will be interested to read that. I've written a textbook, so you know they can read the textbook. But I have to think about the particular audience that I'm trying to reach. If I'm trying to make it to number one bestseller, I'm trying to reach out to the masses, you know, to the mass audience. So I have to think about what topic, would be interesting to a wider audience. So how did I do that? What I did is I actually went on to forums. I went on to communities, you know, Facebook communities, and look at what people are struggling with. You know, I look at discussions and I've noticed that there's a lot of people out there who would be struggling with their mental health. You know, they are experiencing depression. Some of them are experiencing anxiety. You know, there are some women, for example, who are returning to work and finding it difficult to find their feet when they return to work. So, you know, you start on that basis that there are people out there who might need a bit of your help. You know, with me as a psychologist, I know quite a lot of techniques and strategies in psychology that could help people who might be, yes, experiencing depression or need more confidence in their life. So I start off with that grounding. Look at forums, engage in conversation in communities on Facebook, or if you actually can speak to them in person. So for example, if you're thinking about writing a book that would benefit first-time mothers, if you know first-time mothers, go ahead and talk to them. Ask them, you know, what book would you be interested in reading? Ask them, what are your goals, your aspirations? What are you struggling with? What are you scared of as a first-time mother? Ask them and engage in a conversation with your audience, and that will help you to refine and shape what you're going to write about in your book. So topic is really important. Another way to narrow down your topic, and this is what I actually do with my books, is I do keyword research on Amazon. I actually do check out what sort of keywords people are putting in on Amazon when they are looking for a book. So for example, in my first book, you know, Change Your Life for Good, during my keyword research, I found out that there were more than 3,000 searches per month on Amazon that uses that keyword. So I can actually see that people want change in their life. And I thought, okay, I can map that on to my expertise. I know quite a bit about, how to help people change unwanted habits, for example, or how they can change their behavior, or how can they change their environment if they are feeling stuck in a rut. You know, that's part of my expertise. And I can see on Amazon, in the keyword research that people are looking for this. So that's what I deliver. That's what I give, and that's what I write for my audience. It's the same thing with imposter syndrome remedy. Before I started writing that book, I did my keyword research, and I found out that about 4,000 people have been typing in imposter syndrome in the keyword research keyword on Amazon when they search for books on Amazon. And I thought, okay, a lot of people are interested in imposter syndrome. You know, they want to stop feeling as if they are frauds. You know, they want to gain more confidence in what they do. They want to feel, they want to know their value, to embrace their worth. And so that's what I delivered. You know, this is what people are asking for, and that's what I wrote about. The same thing with my third book, Fear is Not My Enemy. During my keyword research, I found that 3,000 searches per month, on Amazon, people are typing in fear. They are typing in overcome fear, how to cope with fear. So I can see that people are hungry for a book that will help them to resolve this problem. And it turns out that, I have that expertise. I have that knowledge and experience, helping people overcome their fears. And that's what I wrote. So that's actually my number one secret. If you want to hit number one bestseller on Amazon in your launch week, make sure that you deliver a book that taps into what people are looking for right now. What do they need? And how can your knowledge, experience, or your book, how can your book help these people who are looking for this particular topic? So that's the first secret. You have to know your audience and write a book that will satisfy your audience needs. What are their goals? What are their aspirations? What are their problems and pain points? And write a book that can help them with that. Okay? So it's actually quite easier to sell your book that way because people are looking for it in the first place. Okay? So that's the number one secret. The second one is all about how you're going to style your book and how you're going to price your book during launch week. So we have this saying that we shouldn't judge the book by its cover. There's this famous saying. Unfortunately, that saying doesn't really apply to books. People do actually judge a book by its cover. And when you go to Amazon, and when you put your book on Amazon, there are millions of books on Amazon. And you need to find a way for your book to stand out in the crowd. There are millions of books there. So what I would suggest, and actually what I do, is I get a professional designer to design my books. I'm not a designer. I don't design my own books, but I know someone who does. Actually, it's my sister. But she's a professional, she's a designer. So she knows about what colors work well, what colors could stand out, and hire a designer to design a book cover for you that will help your book stand out in the Amazon crowd. And the other important thing that you have to recognize is that when people type in and look for books on Amazon, they will type in the keyword and Amazon will suggest some books. People scroll down and all they can see is that little thumbnail on the page, right? They see all these books and all they can see is this thumbnail. So you have to make sure that your book, can be seen, can attract the attention of your target audience, and that your book title can be read as a thumbnail. Because if people cannot actually read what your book is about, it's unlikely that they will click and find out more about your book. So the book cover is really important. You need to style the book in such a way that it will attract your target audience. And you need to make sure that the main title of your book can be read as a small thumbnail. All right, so that's one point in terms of styling. In terms of pricing your book during launch week, you need to be able to reach out to many people, right? And for me, during my launch week, I actually set my book free for 2 days for my advanced readers. So I let it free for my friends and for my family and for my advanced readers so they can download the book for free on Amazon. But for the next 2 or 3 days, I actually set it free on Amazon so people can just download the book and read it. Now, you may be wondering, oh gosh, why is she doing that? Why is she, giving her books away for free? I'll tell you the reason why. The reason why is for the first week, I just want my book in the hands of as many people as possible. And when you set it for free, there's not a lot of hesitation from people to download it. It's free. All they've got to lose is some storage space in their device to download your book. So I would strongly encourage you to set your book for free in the first 2 or 3 days, if you like, so you can actually get more people to download your book. For my first book, when I set it for free, one day I had over 4,000. Hi, Donna. Hi, you made it. Hi. So yes, my first book, when I set it for free, I had over 4,000 downloads when it was free. And it was my hope that it would attract more people, because if people downloaded my book, they read it, and if they loved it, they could recommend it to other people. And that strategy actually worked. For my first book, I had like 4,000 downloads on the day that it was released. And the following day, when I priced it at 99 cents, it became number one bestseller, and I even beat Tim Ferriss's book to the number one spot the next day, because there was some momentum and there was buzz around my book. People downloaded my book, they read it, they loved it, and they recommended it to their friends, and that's it. That helped me get to number one bestseller status, and it's a fantastic feeling. So that's actually secret number two. You need to style your book. It's hi, Tinette. Hi, don't worry. If you're late, you can always watch it on replay. Hi, it's good that you're here. But yes, so you need to style your book, have a really good cover, and have a price. Set it at a price. Make it free for a few days. If you register on Kindle Direct Publishing Select, I talk about this in my course. Actually, there are some regulations on Kindle about this, but you can set it for free for 5 days so you can reach out to more people. They can download your book, and when you set it at 99 cents, you already have this audience, people who are raving about your book, and it is easier to sell in that way. So that's the second secret. Now, the third secret is, hang on a sec. Now we really have to write your book. Oh, yeah, of course, Tinette, you have to write your book. I mean, I was talking about this in the first day, you have to write your book. How are you going to sell your book if you're not writing it? But anyway, let's get back to this session. So the first secret is you need to have a fantastic topic, a topic that people would want to read. Second is you have to style the cover really well and set it at a price that would be attractive to your audience. And the third secret is that I'm really glad that you're here tonight, Donna. I was actually going to give a shout out to you in this live broadcast. But the third secret is the importance of rallying some support when you launch your book. I mean, for me, I don't have a huge social media following, but I do have really close friends, really supportive friends. And yes, Donna, I'm looking at you. Thank you very much. You've been an absolute star. You've been there right from the very start. When I started the self-publishing career, you've been there helping me to promote my book, tweeting it, telling your friends about it. And that's actually the importance of having really good friends, close family members who can help you in promoting your book. So the third secret is rally some support. Get some people to back you up when you launch your book. And actually, even before you launch your book, it's really important that you organize a launch team. Now, what do I mean by that? You need to have a group of people who can read your book in advance, you know, way before you launch your book. They can read it in advance. So by the time you launch your book, they can download it on Amazon for free and leave reviews for you. That way, it's going to be quite easy for other people to see your book and see that there are reviews there already, and it's going to make it more attractive to them to buy your book. And for me, I find it really fascinating because I've actually joined many Facebook communities, and I've built some really good relationships with initially strangers on Facebook. But some of these strangers have been really good friends of mine. You know, we've known each other since I started this self-publishing career. You know, they've been following me for nearly 18 months now to 2 years, you know, since I started. And they've been there. They would read my books in advance. They will be part of my launch team. And by the time I'm ready to launch my books, they will be there to help promote it with me. It's absolutely amazing. I'm not going to mention any names because I don't want to embarrass them, but I know who you are. You know who you are, and you know, you've come to join me when I have my PAMI Code Facebook group, and now I have Self-Publishing Made Simple Facebook group. You know, there are people who followed me and supported me through my journey, and I'm truly forever grateful for these people who have done that. So that's actually my third secret. You know, I'm not doing this on my own. I have some people who are absolutely supportive, you know, friends who come back from way before I start, you know, since university years, you know, since I was a student, they've always been there and really supportive. Up until now, I have supporters whom I've just met on Facebook, initially strangers who are now, you know, my best supporters online, who's always been there whenever I launch something and have something new to present to my audience. So rally some support. That's really important. So that's actually my three secrets for today. The first one is have a fantastic topic. Make sure that the book that you write, the topic that you're writing about, is something that would resonate well with your audience. Make sure that you know your audience. Do your market research. Do your keyword research. And write a book that people will find valuable. You know, people that, you know, books that will be useful for your target audience. That's the first secret. The second secret is style and price. Make sure that you have an amazing book cover, a book cover that will stand out from the millions of books on Amazon. And during launch week, I would strongly encourage you to have a couple of days when you set it for free just to build the momentum around your book. You know, more people will download your book that way. There will be more people reading your book. For launch week, the aim is not really to make tons of money. The aim for launch week is to get your book to as many hands as possible. Get as many people to read your book as possible. And if your book is good and if they loved your book and they resonate with your message, they're going to share that to others, share that with other people, and it's going to have a ripple effect in that way. So that's the second secret. And the third secret is rally some support. You know, have your friends and family to back you up. You know, organize a launch team way before you have your launch, and they will be there to support you when you are ready to launch. So that's it. So those are my three secrets. I hope you found it valuable, you know, for the past couple of days. And if you would like to join us in my, I'm building this community now called the Self-Publishing Made Simple Community. You can join us there. You know, you could connect with fellow authors. You can connect with book lovers in the group. And you can actually connect with me as well, because it's, you know, self-publishing, you know, you learn by experience. And there are certain things that you don't know that you don't know, right? You know, you only realize that you don't know it once you get it, once you get started. So join our group. I will be there every Tuesday, 11 in the morning, UK time, and you can ask me anything in your self-publishing journey. So I can see we have a question, Tinette. What's your question? Do you recommend that we only launch one book at a time, or is it okay to launch two books together? Tinette, I would strongly encourage you to launch one book at a time, so you can just focus on that one book and generate traffic in that book, build a momentum around that book, and launch the second book the next time, maybe after 6 weeks or after 2 months. In that way, you can connect the two books together. You can have book one as part of the series, the second book as, you know, the second book in the series. And when you release the second book, that would actually help promote the first book again. So I would actually encourage you to launch one book at a time and build the momentum in that way. For me, it certainly worked well. You know, every time I released a new book, I can see sales coming back again for my other books, because people can see that I have a new book and they can see that I had previous books. So it helps the books in that way. So yes, to answer your question, just one book at a time. Just focus your attention one book at a time, and then when you're ready, launch the second one. Any other questions? I'm really looking forward to your book, Tinette. I think, you know, your book is going to be spectacular. We're waiting for it. People are waiting for it. And I could certainly support you in the process. Sorry about that. I'm using my phone today. But yeah, if you need support, you know, make time for your book. You know, you learn through experience. Join the PAMI, not the PAMI code. Join the Self-Publishing Made Simple Facebook group. And I'll be there to support you every step of the way, because I'm sure that you will have more questions to come as you gain more experience. You'll figure out that there are more things that you don't know. And I'll be here. I have experience in this, and I'll be more than happy to support you. All right. So I guess that's it. Oh yeah, we ran over. That's it. And for people who are watching this, yes, if you want to come and join us in the Self-Publishing Made Simple community here on Facebook, we have every Monday we set our intentions for the week. You know, if you have a goal in mind, if you want to publish your book, set your intentions. If your intention this week is just to write one chapter, set it on Monday, and come Friday I'll check if you've done that, you know, keep you accountable and keep you on track. And every Tuesday I'll be there, 11 o'clock in the morning UK time. If you have any questions, if you're asking, oh, Emmy, you know, where can I find a designer? Or Emmy, how do I upload my stuff on Kindle? Or what shall I do with my strategy? Where can I find people to support me in my launch? Go there, you know, there will be other authors in there. We can share our journey and support each other in that way. All right, so I guess that's it. Thank you all very much for joining me for these past 3 days. I hope you found it valuable, and I hope to see you in the Self-Publishing Made Simple Facebook group. All right, bye for now. Bye everyone. Bye.